Famous last words, I know, but this really should not be anything to worry about.
I'm Doc Sinners, I'm tried and tested. Check out the style that I perfected. Don't be whining at me like I don't get it. I'm on fire like pyrotechnics. What? Fuck out of here. Imagine if the sun would only come out once every 1,000 years. That's what it's like when someone this renowned appears. Basically, I cause the motherfucking crowd to cheer. You fucking mouse your tears. I'm a sex panther, herbal extractor, verbal neck snapper. Under my patio, there's a lot of dead rappers. English, American, even French rappers. I'm Doc Sinners, I'm tried and tested. Check out the style that I perfected. Don't be whining at me like I don't get it. I'm on fire like pyrotechnics. What?
Really no big deal. Welcome back, everyone. Quelana of Izalith, at your service. Nah, it's just salad. But I am wearing what we picked up from the Tomb of the Daughter of Chaos back in Ceaseless Discharges area, the Gold Hem Black set. Worn by the witch Quelana of Izalith, mother of pyromancy and daughter of chaos. Well, actually, this isn't Quelana's actual clothing. I guess the description says that because if you kill Quelana, you can actually get this set from her as well. Oh well. She wore this gold-hemmed black cloak before even the Age of Fire, and it offers strong resistance versus fire, poison, and other perils. Indeed, as you can see, it has some rather nice resistances, especially against fire and poison, but the physical defense is nothing to write home about, and the other major drawback to it is that it cannot be upgraded. We do cut a fearsome figure in it, though, don't we? Alright then. Back to the shortcut elevator we previously unlocked down in the Demon Ruins. Last time, we slew some mighty foes, but unfortunately, we were also once again forced to put down an old friend. A tragic tale, that, Logan. Ah, well. Tragedies are many in the world of Lordran. And we have not seen the last of them yet. But today, having beaten the Demon Fire Sage, we're going to be going from one boss fight pretty much directly to another. We will very shortly be encountering another boss, and this time it's going to be an actually unique one, not just another texture-swap butt demon. Indeed, we are done with butt demons. There are but three. So we went up this staircase before to open up our shortcut. Now we're going to try the low road. And we've got another fire to spark up. Handy. Also handy is the fact that I've already got a humanity going spare. And I suppose, being as I do have a boss fight coming up, I should probably put away the Great Combustion in favor of the Power Within. This is a boss fight that is simply awkward. It might just be me, but I find this particular boss's tells rather difficult to read, and so it ends up just turning into a bit of a mud fight, with the boss and myself just kind of slugging it out. And yes, I know there is a treasure up there, and I will go chasing after that shortly, but I just want to make sure there's nothing else of importance down here before I do. Yep, it looks like things are pretty clean otherwise. And we do have a nice glowing, grossly incandescent summon sign on the floor there. Could it be? Yep, We're going to have some assistance this time from our good buddy Solaire. And just after joining his covenant, too. So that'll be fun. But first, treasure. Now let's see, how can I get down from here with the lowest possible amount of fall damage? Yeah, I think it's pretty much impossible to get back on the path from here without taking a little bit of hurting. But if I can land on the branch ramp there, it shouldn't be too bad. And I completely failed to do that, but that's alright. Plenty of Estus to go around. Solaire, buddy, how about some jolly cooperation? Praise indeed. Alright. Now, if I recall correctly, this is a rather fiery boss, so I think I might actually do a little better trading this out for the Black Knight option. I don't sacrifice a whole lot of stability that way, and, much better fire resistance than the Eagle Shield. Dear God, what's happening to my frame rate? Okay. Anyway. We're gonna burst mode this bad boy up. Oh, should've put on my lingering ring, but oh well. We'll make the best of it. And no big deal if I don't win the first try. Oh yeah, that creepy centipede thing we saw crawling on the wall up in the ruins? That wasn't just for show. And Solaire here likes to show that his AI is as brilliant as ever by wandering around freely in the lava. Fortunately, he has a ton of HP, so it doesn't completely ruin him as much as it might. Whoa. Yeah, this is just a very awkward fight for me. It's a big enemy with a lot of moving parts. I tend to have a little trouble telling what it's going to do, so really I just kind of try not to get smashed up too much. Keep my guard up and hope for the best. And in close range, it's... Ah! Not good. In close range, its weird geometry tends to make the camera go a little crazy, so that certainly doesn't help any. But it being a tall drink of water means the upward swing of the Great Scythe is quite helpful here. And we are putting a substantial hurt on it, which is also nice. So yeah, the centipede demon, like I said, really tends to be something of a mud fight, because camera shenanigans and just confusing geometry and all that good stuff, but we won, that's the important thing. and for keeping Solaire alive, or more accurately, killing the thing before Solaire can get himself in too much trouble, we got a sunlight medal out of the deal. It's a bonus. But the main thing we need here is the orange charred ring. Reduces lava damage. Well, you can see why that's important in these parts. Since his sores were inflamed by lava from birth, his witch sisters gave him this special ring. But fool that he is, he readily dropped it, and from that spot, a terrible centipede demon was born. Yep, that is the story of Ceaseless Discharge. Also, you know, if there's a ring that, if you drop it on the ground, a terrible centipede demon springs out, that's a little bit of a safety concern, don't you think? Might not have been a bad idea to send that back to the lab for a little more testing. I mean, I know it was probably important to relieve their brother's pain in a hurry, but jeez. Alright, so now that we have the orange charred ring, it's possible to cross the lava semi-safely. It's not 100% damage removal. You do still gradually get hurt by the lava, just nowhere near as fast. And it will really tear up your equipment, so counterproductively, it's probably best to strip naked before you try crossing the lava pool. But we'll do that later. Reason being, there is there's an important turning point here. If we proceed straight onward into Lost Izalith, then a terrible misfortune will befall Solaire. And we've already had enough tragedy for the immediate with Logan and all that. So what we're going to do is do a little backtracking. And the first backtracking we do is going to be to get that item that was guarded by all the Taurus demons. Because now that we have the orange charred ring, we can survive wading out into the lava to pick it up. And also, we're going to have to do a little something to prevent Solaire from having a terrible accident. Because entering into Lost Izalith is the trigger that causes that to happen, so we have to do something to avert that first. So, I think we have enough Estus for the time. Well, actually, you know what? I should cash in some of these souls just to be on the safe side. Let's see. Okay, we just have a single level's worth. So, I feel like being a little more robust. That'll do. Alright, and from here I can certainly get back to the shortcut with a minimum of difficulty. So that's exactly how we're gonna play this. And then we can rock, but we can walk straight down from the Fair Ladies area to the entrance of the Demon Ruins and get our prize. That fire effect billowing out from under our black dress is kind of a neat-looking contrast, if I do say so myself. And then down we go along this familiar pathway, and we will soon arrive at the Taurus Demon area. Easy peasy. Well, dealing with that many Taurus demons in rapid succession might not exactly be easy peasy, but getting to them will be. No time for love, Eggman. Alright, so this is definitely not a crew we want to fight with in any kind of mass. So, time to put the bow back on and, kind of coax them out one at a time. Well, he noticed that shot, but it wasn't quite far enough to hit him. We need him good and angry. Come on, Black Bow of Ferris, you can do better than that. You have the best range in the game. Maybe a little higher? I don't think that did any damage, but it got his attention, and that's the important part. Nothing too special about this flavor of Taurus Demon. Nothing we haven't encountered before. Certainly hits harder than the original version, but can't take as much of a beating. And this is bound to get a little tedious and repetitive, for which I apologize. Well, this one sure likes the jumping strike. Whoopsie. Gotta say, it is satisfying to drop these once, tough guys with such speed. Just wanna make sure the Capra Demon doesn't aggro to me. Don't need any goat men messing with us while we're taking out the bull men. These guys must look farther away than they are because of their height. Or look closer than they are because of their height, rather. I keep thinking I'm gonna get their attention and it just doesn't happen. Also, even though it's nothing that I'm gonna use, I'm a little disappointed that none of them have dropped an axe for me yet. I have very fond memories of that axe. Really lovely weapon if you're doing a strength playthrough. Predictably sluggish, of course, but God, does it hit hard. Oh, hi, I didn't even see the one over there. Oh, speak of the devil. Lovely, lovely demon's great axe. Oh, caught him right in the bicep. Whoosh. Okay, good opportunity to pop that one I didn't see before. I seem to have shot him in the foot. And picked up another great axe. Not that I need even one of them, let alone two. I noticed he splashed through the lava a little bit. I don't know if that actually hurts them. I wonder. Whoop! Well, it was bound to happen eventually. But oh, how we shall punish it. Oh my god, did I arrow him in the dick? Sorry, Minotaur. I really wasn't aiming there. Interrupted. Now we're starting a collection of demons' great axes. And getting some decent souls for these guys. Unlike the Capras, they actually do give you a semi-respectable reward. So we will have another level up in our future very soon. And I am fairly certain, unless they're really hiding against the backdrop, that's the last one right there. And we will be able to claim our prizes. Satisfying indeed. Now, there are a couple of major treasures over here. I think the one sitting smack in the middle of the lava is the main one we've come for, but I think there might be a soul item or two here as well. In any case, lava means it's bikini season. Anything over in the corner here doesn't look that way.
Oh!
Wow, I'm kind of an idiot. Note to self, just holding the orange ring doesn't actually do any good for you. It requires that you actually put the thing on yourself.
Welp,
that was foolish. I'm going to have to carve back through some minotaurs, so I'll be back in a little while. Oh, hey, how about that? The Taurus demons don't actually respawn in this area. Well, that's nice of them. Alright, that's certainly going to save a little time here. Now then, let's find my soul pile, because there was enough there that I would very much like to recover it. And despite bikini season not looking nearly as fetching as it did before I went hollow, we are going to make absolutely, positively positive we put on the orange charred ring. Yes, very important. All right, onward. The Chaos Flame Ember, that's what we came for. As you can see, running around in lava still kinda hurts. But it's a hell of a lot more bearable than it was before when, you know, it kinda killed me in seconds. I should be able to get up here somewhere. Come on, I know that's reachable. There we go. I think this is just a soul item, but soul items are worth collecting. Really having problems with my words lately. Alright, I think that is pretty much everything we need to do in the Demon Ruins. However, that is not everything we have to do before proceeding to Lost Izalith. Because we have a friend we would very much not like to lose. And we will have to take some precautions to keep him from being killed. Well, not killed so much as meet another terrible fate, which I will show you in the New Game Plus abridged run. But for now, we want Solaire to make it through the game hale and hearty. So for starters, a quick rest for levels. This time I'm going to brain up a bit. And we are gonna head right back down the fair lady's personal elevator to right around where we fought the fire sage. Why am I still not wearing anything? That's better. Oop. Gotta go the right way, though. Hello again, statues. Ah, lots of dexterity plus the great scythe is a pleasure to have. It is very satisfying to be able to one-shot a late-game enemy, even if it is a Zako. And now, down that way was the centipede demon. I have a little bit of sense of direction, I swear. I suppose we should have a quick glance at that ember. In the key items. Chaos Flame Ember is an art of the lost city of Izalith, handled only by blacksmiths knowledgeable in ancient weapons. And that allows you to take weapons along the Chaos Path. Chaos weapons inflict fire damage, and they also scale according to how much humanity you have in your pool. Up to 10 humanity, I think, is the most they can get out of it. Now then, we're going to want to take out this statue so it doesn't end up chasing us. Two statues, actually. Okay, I don't think they really care enough. So we'll just go on ahead. Whoop! Meant to get onto the ledge there. Not meant to be this time. That's okay. Don't think it's anything that important. And starting in this area, we will start to encounter some chaos bugs. They mainly run away from us. No big deal as enemies go. Although they do occasionally drop sunlight metals, so if you don't want to do co-op, but you want to level up in the Sunbro Covenant, these guys are your opportunity for that. I think they can also drop red titanite chunks, but I'm not positive about that. Now this door... Whoop! Okay, that's what I was afraid of. This door is the one that can only be opened if you are at +2, I believe, in the Servants of Chaos. That's why I fed all that humanity into the Fair Lady earlier. However, it would appear that leaving the Chaos Servants Covenant before actually opening the door gave me enough of a covenant penalty that I do not get to do that right away. Just checking for treasure here. But I have plenty of humanity. I can go back and rejoin the Chaos Servants and rank myself up again. Not a huge deal. No goodies here. Some goodies on the other side. We'll see if I have an opportunity to get over there from this direction. Alright, maybe if I do a nice leap from here. That seems to suffice nicely. More souls. We like souls. Okay, looks like I need to drop down into the hall again. So, next objective is to roll on back to the fair lady and fill her up with more humanity. And I am okay with that, because once again, I certainly have the humanity to spare, and it's a good deed. It makes her feel a little better. And we do like the fair lady, yes we do. I can't say for sure she's the most lovable spider lady I've ever met, because there sure have been a lot of those in my life, but she's definitely up there. Top 5 easy. Warm up my feet again. I feel so toasty. Okay, very good. We've got our rank back up to +2. We've gotten our skin treatment. We're looking healthy again. And now time to head back down to the door. We're becoming very familiar with this particular set of demon statues. Oh well, good exercise for our scythe arm. And some relatively easy souls, nothing wrong with that. Not a great quantity, but every little bit is a little bit further toward our next level up, or major purchase. Okay, you remember the path. Not gonna worry about the statues this time, they didn't seem too inclined to follow us. And down we go. I don't know that it's strictly necessary to kill all the chaos bugs here. But, you know, it's easy and we might get free stuff for it, so might as well. Yep, praise the sun. And our sun, bro, is why we do such a thing. That's more like it. Now, the important thing we have to find here is a special... What the...
You might have heard of me, son. I am the sun. I've done it. I have. I see. I see. Oh. Oh.
Oh. Well, shit. That is not how this was supposed to happen. I think something glitched because, yeah, this really shouldn't happen. Typically what happens if you go into Lost Izalith before killing the special chaos bug up ahead, then it burrows into Solaire's head and makes him go crazy, thinking he is the sun, and he attacks you, and that is the tragic fate of Solaire. But this time I did everything right, as far as I can tell, and... he still went crazy. I did not path into Lost Izalith at any point. I'm quite certain of that. Well, it would appear that New Game Plus is when I will have to rescue Solaire, and hopefully it will work that time. I'm sorry, folks. This is definitely not a tragedy I was intending. Well, this is no life for a great warrior of the sun such as our good buddy Sunbro. So, I think the only right thing we can do is to put him down like we did Logan, so he doesn't have to go on living this parody of life. Sorry, Solaire. I think it was the game code that failed you here, rather than strictly me failing you, but... nevertheless, I cannot help but feel responsible.
Oh, my son. It's dark. So dark.
Oh, Solaire. I'm sorry, buddy. Your sun burned for a short time, my friend, but it burned very, very brightly. Well, this is the only way you can really get his equipment, is to kill him, whether it's when he's aggro on you or not. But it just doesn't seem worth the reward. Tears indeed. There is the red-eyed chaos bug. Typically, if you can kill this thing before you path into Lost Izalith, then it never gets a chance to infect Solaire, and all is well. But things just didn't happen the way they should. Well, now we're in Lost Izalith for the first time. Up ahead, there's a Titanite demon. It is the most powerful Titanite demon in the game, and generally not worth fighting, but it does have one benefit. It is the only Titanite demon that respawns, so it's a good way of farming demon Titanite if you ever need to. Let's pick up our treasure here and then take a look at some of our tragically acquired equipment. First of all, much as it was by Solaire, the sunlight maggot can be worn on the head. It is a loathsome parasite that inhabits Lost Izalith. It is completely immobile, yet still lives. Well, it seemed pretty mobile to me. I guess they mean, after we killed it, it's still technically alive, maybe? Well, when worn on the head, it emanates blinding light, which is why it is known as a sunlight maggot. And this is actually the most convenient light source. If you wear it in your on your head in the upcoming dark area that we will have when we go for the final Lord Soul, then you have a nice, reliable, non-expiring light source. It can also be traded to Snuggly the Crow to get the old witch's ring, which is the other way that you can get said ring without taking it as your starter gift. And that is why I said that getting the old witch's ring otherwise is kind of a pain in the ass. Let's see, we got poor Solaire's feathered bucket. Helm of Solaire of Astora, Knight of Sunlight. Mourn you till I join you. Of high quality, but lacking any particular powers. Solaire's incredible prowess must have come from rigorous training alone, for his equipment exhibits no special traits. Yep, Solaire was just a plain old badass. The large holy symbol of the sun, while powerless, was painted by Solaire himself. An artist, too. And if I recall correctly, he also painted the sun on his talisman. Upstanding, unwavering faith, which, sadly, could not hold up against a bug in the brain. I'm really sad about that. I really thought I did this right. I'm really thinking that the game just glitched out, because a few event triggers are a little wonky in the PC version of Dark Souls, but if any of you can think of anything that I did incorrectly, please let me know. Oh yes, there was one other thing I was going to do here. I was going to show you one of the new enemy types in Lost Izalith. Oh, by the way, this path to Lost Izalith that can be opened with the Chaos Servant Covenant. This is a shortcut that allows you to skip a non-trivial chunk of the area. We're not going to take it because I want to do the area properly, but you do need to open it to save Solaire, when that works correctly. And down there we have a number of funky-looking enemies that are the Bounding Demons of Izalith. Or so they're officially called. What the Bounding Demons of Izalith actually are undead dragon asses. Yeah, you remember the undead dragons that are in the Valley of the Drakes and the one that we actually fought in the Painted World of Ariamis? I think it must have been a Friday evening at the FromSoft offices. They were struggling to get the game finished and go home for the weekend. They were just like, we need some new enemies for Lost Izalith. Just create a big lava pit area and copy-paste some of those undead dragons' asses into it. Give them some attack animations and we'll call it a day. Anyway, the Bounding Demons of Izalith were actually a major threat in the original release of the game, but then it was patched to greatly decrease their aggro radius, so now they don't attack unless you get really close to them, so you can avoid them for the most part. But they give some okay souls, and they don't respawn, so we can take some of them out from the bridge here. Don't remember if they poison or not. I don't believe they do. Oh, and one of the best explanations I ever heard for these guys was that they're here because dragon asses all go to hell, so the upper halves are all in heaven. Well, I suppose that's as sensible a place as any for the naughtiness of being to reside is in the ass. Yeah, these are a non-responding enemy. If I can just take some of them out now, then I'll be able to walk around a little more freely when I take the proper path through Lost Izalith. And I'll get their souls, which is always a nice bonus. Oh, and one other thing about the Bounding Demons is that they're fairly rare among enemies in this game in that they are a major threat to each other. Bounding Demons can actually very easily do friendly fire to each other. And back in the original release of the game, where they would actually aggro on you from a decent distance, one of the best ways to get past them was to just get them all killing each other. Now here's one nice and close up. Unfortunately, they have a tendency to wander about a bit when you pincushion them. Which certainly makes it tougher than it would otherwise be to take them down once and for all. But this is really just a convenience and extra souls thing, so it really doesn't matter how many of them I ultimately get from here. I'll definitely say this is one of the wackier cases of reused assets I've seen in modern gaming. Any more I can hit from here? Nah, it's not looking that way. Alright, well, I took out two of them. That'll be a start. I believe we have a good distance vantage on them later in the regular path, if we need it. God, poor Solaire. I hope things work properly on the second try. Hey, folks. I stopped back up in Firelink to get my 20 Estus. But there's another thing I can briefly demonstrate while I'm here. A somewhat little-known and fairly useless but kind of amusing quality of the Orange Charred Ring is that it gives you fiery feet. Yep. I can kick people on fire. It's not exactly a powerful attack, but, well, it's a thing you can do. Alright then, I think I've got close to enough souls for a level, so I'm going to pop a consumable or two, and then we will roll on back and do Lost Izalith. Or get started, anyway. Let's see how many souls I actually need. 30k. And one more of those, I believe. Yeah, that ought to do it. Okay, equipment is good. So up we go. More brains. We'll get that crystal magic weapon eventually. Let's see, is there actually a closer... Nope, we'll need to go back to the Fair Lady. No big deal. That's what that shortcut is for. And being human, as usual, does render us somewhat susceptible to invasion. But it's not really a terrible thing overall, because there is an NPC invasion that we're going to want in Lost Izalith, so we'll be able to get that activated. Said NPC invasion is going to be the final appearance of Kirk Knight of Thorns, and when we've had all the possible fights with Kirk, then we'll eventually be able to get all of his gear. I don't expect to be using the Thorns equipment, but we like to collect things, yes we do. Okay, I think I do have my orange shard ring on, so that's good. We will definitely want to get ready for bikini season. And it's actually not a frightening shriveled bikini season this time. I think there might be a soul item or two around here somewhere. We'll do a quick check of the area. Well, that's not a soul item, but I'll take it anyway. And somewhere around here, there will be a path for us. What is this? I don't think that's an actual door. Nothing we can do anything with. That, I guess, is not the path I was looking for. I forget where the actual exit we need for this place is. Ah, this would be it. And it looks like we're right around hitting the 1 hour mark. So I suppose this is an okay time to leave off. Didn't make quite as much progress as I intended because of the whole having to charge up humanity thing. Oh, you know what? I did charge up humanity in the Daughters of Chaos, so we'll keep going for a little while because that'll mean some edit time. Alright. Not too far from here, I believe, is where we will start to encounter the first bounding demons on our actual walking level. Is there any treasure over in the lava there? Nope, 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 nope. Not that I can see, anyway. So, the bounding demons can't really actually fit through this narrow area here, so this is a good place to snipe some of them from, if you just want to get them out of the way. Again, post-patching, their actual aggro radius is so low that they're not really going to mess with me. But just getting them out of the way makes things a little safer and more convenient to run around. We can see some of their attack animations because they will try to hit me from here even though they can't. There is that huge tail sweep, which has a very wide range. Can't actually hit us, though. And there's that big, massive hang time jump into the air, which is what gives them the name of Bounding Demons. Good thing about that jump, though, is that it doesn't really have any homing qualities. So as long as you're not standing where you were when the thing comes back down, it should miss you. But its landing does have some AoE qualities, so you will want to get a good distance away from that spot. We'll give our friend some room here. Don't give up so easy, come on. Get back over here. Dragon asses never surrender. I do have to admit, I think the lava splash looks kind of cool when they come back down from one of their bounces. That's right, get back here. Alright, looks like that's all the bounding demons I can readily hit from here. So we'll just keep going a little longer. And eventually we will come to a new bonfire hidden behind an illusory wall. I have a decent recollection of roughly where that is. I do hate all the damnable bloom in this area. Makes things a little hard to see, honestly. And there's a tower we should be able to get inside of. Damn it all. And the reduced visibility, which for once is due to too much light rather than not enough, does mean it takes a little caution to make sure you walk in safe places and don't attract the attention of any bounding demons. Because if they do aggro on you in a place where they can actually get to you, they can actually be genuinely a bit dangerous. Because their attacks do hit hard, and they do have a lot of attack range. You, on the other hand, are sight fodder. Now let's see, is this the tower that has the actual bonfire in it? I'm not altogether certain. Ha! Got you slipping. Oh shit. Got a little too close there. Okay, well, I think I'm safe in here. And there's a chest. I can't see the chain, so... Okay, should be safe. Ooh, great hero. That's quality soul. Let's see if we can take out a few more of these guys from here. I think their attack range is such that they might actually be able to hit me a little bit through the wall, but... as long as I'm careful and stay back as far as I'm able, shouldn't be too massive a danger. Looks like the AoE from the balance landing will not catch me. Maybe these guys will do a little damage to each other, which would be nice. I don't think they ever actually aggro on each other. Their hits just damage each other. It would be cool if you could get some monster infighting going, a la Doom. But, alas, no such luck. So yeah, this is not actually the tower that has the bonfire in it, because that one has an illusory wall that we will have to open. But it does let us play cover shooter for a little while, so that's convenient. Glad I brought plenty of arrows. I do have to say, they have some mighty impressive ups for a creature of that size. But then again, when you are literally nothing but legs and glutes, I suppose that'll happen. Oh, one of them just died for no reason I can tell, so, guess there must have been a team kill there somewhere. And I ain't gonna knock it. Anything that means I get this done a little faster and don't have to use quite so many of my arrows is aces by me. Sadly, I don't think these things can ever drop anything. Whoa. He was closer than he looked. Oh. Close enough to hit me through the wall, even. That's no fun. Where'd he come down? Kinda lost track of him. No leaving. Stay forever. But no wall hacks. I kill big butts, and I cannot lie. Man, I'm gonna be most of the way to another level after all this. Hey. No leaving. So yeah, you're probably seeing why these could be a bit of a threat. Because they can hit you for quite a bit of damage, and you've seen how surprisingly fast in range covering they could be when they get their minds to it. Where did it even land? Oh, hey there, big guy. Ah, you're stuck on the map, aren't you? Sucks to be you. Sucks to get kicked and stomped on. Sucks to be down to 50-odd arrows, too, but there are worse problems to have. That's right, you head back to your spawn location, and we'll go another round. There we go. Alright, I think I've wasted enough time on that. I see, I think, the tower that I need up ahead. So we will hustle on over to there with a quickness, so we can put our end to the adventures of today. I do not remember which wall is the illusory one, only that there is one. And that's all we truly need to know. Especially when there's a helpful message there for us. Ah, what the hell. Let's pop some more souls and finish out the day with another level. Let's see, will that be enough? It will! And I think I'm going to continue upgrading my brains. Alright, we'll do some speedy repairs. Need to find some place that I can do a pose without having the bonfire prompt pop up. That's better. Alright then. There was some unexpected tragedy today, but at least we did make our early ingression into Lost Izalith, so I suppose it hasn't been all bad. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you again very soon for more sexy naked adventures in Lost Izalith. Till then, this is Un and Salad, wishing you the best. My thanks as always to those noble warriors of sunlight keeping the faith, especially those high-ranked Covenant members, such as Justin Carpenter, Nolden, Zangamarth, Charlie Dunst, Anonymous Benefactor, John Madigan, Johnny Millennium, Sanguine Games, Joseph Coco, Canis, Misha Van Doren, Craig Patterson, and Frank Greasy. Thank you all. Thanks to all watchers, subscribers, commenters, and what have you. And watch out for those chaos bugs. See you soon.